Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. In this video, I will discuss about phenylketonuria. Phenylketonuria was first described by Dr. as born following a Norwegian physician and biochemist in 1934. Dr. Folling observed that individuals with the condition had elevated levels of phenylketones in their urine, which led him to investigate further. His work laid the groundwork for the understanding of phenylketonuria as a genetic metabolic disorder and contributed significantly to the development of diagnostic methods for the condition. Phenylalanine is an essential amino acid, and its metabolism is crucial for maintaining various physiological processes. The primary pathway for phenylalanine catabolism is through its conversion to tyrosine, that is another amino acid, which then enters various metabolic pathways. Proper metabolism of phenylalanine is essential for producing neurotransmitters and other bioactive molecules, as well as for maintaining normal brain function. Phenylalanine is converted to tyrosine by the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. This reaction requires tetrahydrobiaserine, that is BH4, as a cofactor. This reaction primarily occurs in the liver. Phenylketonuria, that is PKU, is a genetic metabolic disorder characterized by the inability to metabolize the amino acid phenylalanine due to a deficiency in the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase, and phenylalanine cannot be effectively converted to tyrosine. This results in the accumulation of phenylalanine in the blood and is converted into phenylpyruvate and other metabolites, which can be harmful especially to the brain and cause intellectual disability and other neurological problems. Prevalence rate of PKU is 1 in 10,000 to 15,000 live births worldwide. It is more common in individuals of European descent, with estimates ranging from 1 in 10,000. The prevalence is lower in population of Asian and African descent, with rates typically less than 1 in 1 lakh live births. Symptoms include intellectual disability, behavioral problems and psychiatric symptoms, eczema, seizures and musty odor in the breath, skin and urine due to the accumulation of phenylketones. PKU is caused by mutation in the phenylalanine hydroxylase gene, which encodes the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. This enzyme is responsible for converting phenylalanine into tyrosine. Without this enzyme, phenylalanine accumulates and leads to toxic effects. Phenylalanine hydroxylase gene, that is PAR gene, is located on long arm of chromosome 12 at position 23.2 and consists of 12 exons. Size of PAR gene is about 19 kb and encodes 453 amino acids long PAR enzyme. Different types of mutation in phenylalanine hydroxylase genes are reported globally, like point mutations, insertion deletions, missense mutations, and nonsense mutations. In point mutations, single nucleotide changes that can disrupt enzyme function. Small insertions or deletions of nucleotide changes the reading frame of the gene. Missense mutations change a single amino acid in the enzyme, which affects enzyme's activity. Nonsense mutations create a premature stop coding, leading to a truncated and non-functional enzyme. The specific mutations in phenylalanine hydroxylase gene can affect the severity of PKU. Some mutations lead to a more severe form of the disorder, while other may result in a milder phenotype. Phenylketonuria is inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern. It can be diagnosed typically by blood test, urine test, and genetic testing. Blood test is done to measure the concentration of phenylalanine in blood. The normal level of phenylalanine is generally less than 2 micrograms per liter, and level greater than 6 mg per deciliter can suggest PKU. Urine test shows increased level of phenylketonuria, such as phenylactic acid and phenylpyruvate acid. These compounds are byproduct of phenylalanine metabolism and can be detected in the urine of individuals with PKU. Genetic testing confirms the diagnosis of phenylketonuria by identifying mutation in the phenylalanine hydroxylase gene, which is responsible for producing the enzyme. In many countries, all newborns are screened for PKU as part of the routine neonatal testing, often within the first few days after birth. The screening involves taking a small blood sample from heel prick to test for elevated level of phenylalanine. If PKU is not diagnosed and not treated in the early stages of life, symptoms may become apparent within the first months. These can include failure to thrive, slow growth and work, weight gain, delayed motor skills, speech and cognitive milestones, intellectual disability, seizures, eczema-like rashes, microcephaly, distinctive odour, etc. Management and therapy for PKU focus on controlling phenylalanine levels through dietary modifications and other supportive measures. Individuals with PKU need to adhere to a strict lifelong low phenylalanine diet. This involves limiting or avoiding high protein foods such as meat, poultry, fish, dairy products, egg, legumes, and nuts, etc. Quan, that is sapropterin dihydrochloride, is a medicine that helps some people with PKU process phenylalanine more effectively by enhancing the activity of the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. It is not effective for everyone with PKU, but it may reduce the need for strict dietary restriction in some cases. Recent advances have introduced enzyme replacement therapies as a potential treatment for PKU. Palisic is an enzyme substitution therapy approved for patients aged 18 years and older, help break down phenylalanine in the blood. This treatment can significantly lower phenylalanine levels and help some patients achieve better control over their condition, although it does not replace the need for a low phenylalanine diet. Women with PKU who are pregnant need to closely control their phenylalanine levels, as high level of phenylalanine during pregnancy can cause significant harm to the developing fetus, leading to intellectual disability and other birth defects. Strict dietary management is crucial during pregnancy to prevent maternal phenylalanine levels from rising. This is all about phenylketonuria. Thanks for watching my video. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel for more health insights. Share this video with your friends and family to spread awareness. If you have any queries or personal experience, please drop comment in comment box. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of yourself. Thank you. Thank you.